I think it would be good to do one more Bayes' theorem example, however, at the start of class today. It's the one that some of you had trouble with, came to my office hours for, this one about printers. This is an example where there's three events representing printers A, B, and C that effectively make up the entire sample space because you are sending your printing job to one of those three printers. So one of those three has to happen, and they can't. Any two of them can't happen at the same time. They're printed at different speeds. Programs are routed to the first available printer. The probability that a program is routed to printers A, B, and C are 0.6, 0.3, and 0.1 respectively. Notice that those numbers add up to 1. Occasionally, a printer will jam and destroy a printout. The probability that a printers A, B, and C will jam are 0.01, 0.05, and 0.04, respectively. So A is the most trustworthy, and that's nice that it gets the most jobs as well. You send your program to be printed, and it jams. What's the probability that it was A? What's the probability that it was B? What's the probability that it was C? It's not clear from this problem statement that this is about conditional probabilities, right? You don't see the word conditional anywhere. You have to realize that from the context, from the way the problem is phrased, from the problem solving process. What kind of problem solving process am I talking about? It certainly wouldn't hurt to draw a Venn diagram here. You're sending the job to one of these three printers. One of these three printers is going to get the job, A, B, or C. So it'd be good to mark off the entire Venn diagram with three regions representing those three picture printers. And it certainly wouldn't hurt. You might even say it might be kind of fun to make the relative area of each printer equal to these probabilities, 0.6, 0.3, and 0.1. So make A the biggest one and slightly over half. B is 0.3, about half as big as A. And C is 0.1. So I've tried to make the areas of those three regions, if I think of the entire box as being an area of 1, approximately areas 0.6, 0.3, 0.1. Next bit of information we got about the jamming. You know, you hope usually printers don't jam, but sometimes they do. The probability that printers A, B, and C will jam are 0.01, 0.05, and 0.04. These are probabilities of jamming given that, well, in this case, it got sent to printer A. In this case, it got sent to printer B. In this case, it got sent to printer C. You don't see the phrase given that either, but that needs to be understood. If it's sent to A, the probability that it will jam is 0.01. If it's sent to B, the probability of jamming is 0.05. If it's sent to C, that's the probability of jamming. These are conditional probabilities. You could say, you could write them down. Probability of jamming, if it's sent to A, is 0.01. Probability of jamming given, or if it's sent to B, is 0.05. And the probability of jamming given that it's sent to printer C is 0.04. And once again, if you want to think in terms of areas, if I want to make the jamming event in red, well, I should make it fairly small. Usually the jobs don't jam. I'd want to effectively make something that's, say, 1% of A's area, maybe about that big. 5% of B's area might be about that big. And 4% of C's area, maybe you cut it off about there to make it look like it's about 4% of C's area. This little area right here is supposed to be 1% of the entire area of A because of that. This area is supposed to represent 5% of the area of the B region. And this area is supposed to represent 4% of the area of the C region. So this is just drawing and writing down what you're given. Your program is destroyed when the printer jams. You're assuming the printer has jammed. You don't know what printer it was sent to. What is the probability that it was A, B, or C? You're trying to find this kind of conditional probability. It's given that it has jammed. Notice that's got A and J switched around from this. It is a different kind of conditional probability. The thing on the right is always the given that. The thing on the left is always what you're trying to find the probability of. Now, I could just write down the formula for Bayes' theorem from scratch here or look it up in the book, but I think it's better to think about it in terms of the definition of conditional probability and then that general multiplication rule. The definition of conditional probability is that this is the ratio of two probabilities. The top is the probability of both events happening, unconditional probabilities, divided by the probability of the thing that's given. Again, it's like you're shrinking the sample space effectively. In this case, you're shrinking it to just the J region. You've shrunk the sample space. What's the probability that it's A? Effectively, this area here, while it was 1% of the area of the A box, what percent of the area of the J oval region is it? Probably bigger than 1%, right? Just looking at it, if this is a semi-accurate picture, probably bigger than 1%. So that's the definition of conditional probability, but to find the top and the bottom, the numerator and denominator, I need to use the general multiplication rule. With the top, use it, but don't use it using that conditional probability because that's what we're trying to find. Instead, use that one. Conditional probability of J given A times the unconditional probability of A. And with this one, before I use the general multiplication rule, think about breaking J into three pieces, the union of three mutually exclusive events. J intersect A, union with J intersect B, union with J intersect C. J intersect A is that little region right there. J intersect B is this middle region right there. J intersect C is this right region over here. They are mutually exclusive and their union is all of J. Therefore, by axiom three, the addition rule for mutually exclusive events, I can write this as a sum of three probabilities. I mean, maybe on an exam, it feels too slow to try to rethink about this from scratch. But I think it's not a bad idea to do it on homework. And as you're prepping for exams, then not a bad idea to do this. And again, with each of these three terms, you use the general multiplication rule with these three conditional probabilities. And in fact, the first one's going to be the same as the numerator. The conditional probability of J given A times the probability of A. The second one is the conditional probability of J given B times the probability of B, plus finally the conditional probability of J given C times the probability of C. Now you can plug in all your numbers, get your answer. I could do that right away here, but let me do something else. Bit of advice for an exam. It's quicker to solve a problem like this in the time rush of an exam, whoops, by making a tree diagram to organize all your information. It's somewhat intuitive as well. You got the three printers here. A, B, and C. And in either case, any one of those cases, it either jams or doesn't jam. It's only the jam branches that are relevant, but I'm writing the jam prime, the complement of jamming anyway, meaning it doesn't jam. Label the branches with the probabilities. Probability of A is 0.6. Probability of B is 0.3 and C is 0.1. Those are the probabilities that it's routed to those printers. And these branches get labeled with these conditional probabilities. 0.01, 0.05, and 0.04. Again, it's not necessary, but if you wanted to, you also could label these branches with 0.99, 0.95, and 0.96. Not necessary for solving the problem. Then multiply along the branches. That's going to give you these products that you see in this fraction. So we got 0.6 times 0.01. That'll be 0.006. We've got 0.3 times 0.05. What will that be? 0.015, I think. Do it in my head. Sounds right. Double check it in your head. And then finally, 0.1 times 0.04 is 0.004. Those are the numbers that go in this fraction. The final answer for this first probability that we're after, I've done the products. The numerator is going to be 0.006. The denominator is going to be 0.006 plus 0.015 plus 0.004. So we get 0.006 divided by what? 0.025? Hey, I don't even need a calculator for that. That's 6/25 or 24/100. Looks like it's 0.24. And actually, from the other one, from the setup, the other ones are pretty easy to figure out. The bottom stays the same. It's the top that changes. For the probability that it's B, if you know it jams, that's 0.015 divided by 0.025, 15/25, which is 3/5, or 0.6. And the probability that C, given that it jams, is 0.004 over 0.025, 4/25, which is 16/100, or 0.16. And these answers, 0.24, 0.6, and 0.16, do add up to 1. If you know it's jammed, it's got to be one of those three printers. That's the cause, or where it's jammed. Those are the answers that you should have gotten.